So today we're going to be doing my empties video. I have a giant bin full of things that I have used up. So we're going to talk about pros and cons. Will I repurchase them again? Or is it something that I don't recommend? Is it a favorite? Yada, yada, yada. So these are like mini reviews all in one video. So let's get started. So the first product I have is from Hask. This is their Keratin Smoothing Shampoo. Absolutely love it. I already have another bottle in my bathroom. The only thing that I don't like about this is that it lathers a lot, so don't put too much. Otherwise, you're going to be struggling to rinse it all out of your hair. It is a very clarifying shampoo, even though it's not meant to be, but it does give my hair a lot of shine, and it does help cut down on the frizz as well. Next thing I have is from Curls. I picked this up at Target. This is their Cashmere Curls Gel. I absolutely loved this back in the day. I decided to repurchase it just to see if I still like it just as much, and I don't. It gives my curls a nice bit of shine and definition, but it's just not something that I would keep purchasing. I think this is like $16 or something at Target, and I found better products since then. Next product is nail polish remover. I always use 100% acetone. I don't waste my time with anything else because it just takes 10 times longer. So whether I'm removing normal nail polish or just gel or acrylics, which I just did and it was a pain, I definitely just use 100%. And if it is harsh on my skin, I will mix a little bit of water and glycerin, and that helps kind of soften it up a little bit. But honestly, straight up acetone is the way to go. From Drunk Elephant, I have the C. Firma Day Serum. I did a whole video about this, basically wasted this $80 because I didn't use it in time and it's since passed. So this is practically full, but it has that weird amber color. It smells really strong. It's been too long, so it's time to toss it. Another Drunk Elephant product is right here. This is the Proteini. I'm surprised at how quickly this ran out. For some reason, I just expected more than that. I don't even think it was 6 months. Maybe I'm using too much, but I really don't think that's the case. Anyway, I love the Proteini. It's one of my favorites. I'm definitely going to repurchase it a little bit later on because right now I'm on a budget. I think 6 months leading up to my wedding, I am going to repurchase that one. Got two hair products from Garnier Fructis. I did a whole routine video using just Garnier Fructis products, and honestly, I really like them. They're affordable. I have come back to using silicone in products as long as they are affordable. So I have here the Curl Treat Smoothie Defining Hair Cream, and then I have the Curl Sculpt Conditioning Cream Gel. I like these both equally, and I do use them both at the same time, even though I don't really need to. I like layering products into my hair. So this is the Smooth and Tame Thermal Protect Milk from Shea Moisture. I had a love-hate relationship with this. I feel like it didn't really do that much when it comes to protecting my hair. A little goes a long way because it would weigh down my hair and then it wouldn't straighten properly. So I like the smell, I like the consistency, but I probably wouldn't repurchase it. Another Drunk Elephant product. This is the Baby Facial from Drunk Elephant, like I just said. Absolutely amazing. It is the most exfoliating chemical mask ever. It is expensive, but that's another product that I'll probably repurchase 6 months before my wedding because the way it makes my skin feel is like nothing else in this world. I do have some alternatives like from Good Molecules that are a little bit cheaper, and I do get similar results, but nothing compares to the Baby Facial. So this is the Color Balance Purple Shampoo. I used to be a blonde and I loved using this. So the way I use purple shampoo is I use it on dry hair and I leave it on for a really long time, at least an hour before my shower. And the reason I do that is A, because I feel like it works better. I would test it a little bit before doing it for that long of a time because sometimes it does give my hair a slight purpley tinge. Like when it was blonde, it would make it a little purple, a little bit lavender, but I really like that effect and it would eventually fade. So this purple shampoo is good, but I like the Provana, the Perfect Blonde, a little bit more than this. The jar is really gross right now because of where it was. This is a body scrub that my friend sells. She has an online shop. I did feature it in my small business owners playlist. Like, I was supporting businesses during the pandemic that were primarily owned by people of color. I will put that playlist up in the cards as well as down below, but this is one of her body scrubs. I definitely like it. It's like an aromatherapy body scrub and it was very relaxing. So I do like this, and I have another one, so I'm not gonna repurchase anything just yet. I finished up a bottle of sunscreen. This is the Hawaiian Tropic Silk Hydration sunscreen, and it's amazing. I love it. I love the smell of it. I use it every single year, and I try to get it at Target when it's on sale just because I feel like the prices have been increasing just a little bit. But yeah, I'm always switching up my sunscreen, but I like to look for things that smell good. Another product, I still have quite a bit of this left, but this is very old. I'm talking probably older than 2015, so I feel like it's just time for it to go. This is from Formula 10.06. Actually, I forgot how they say this brand. I don't remember, but I remember always being so confused by it. because it's a 10.06, but I know there's a way that they say it. I just don't remember. I got this at Ulta. This is a very affordable skincare brand that I do really like. I haven't used it in a couple years, but it was a lot of fun. This is their Pores Be Pure Skin Clarifying Mud Mask. I definitely like it. It has strawberry in it. Smells great, feels good. Again, that price point is great when it comes to skincare. You get 3.4 fluid ounces. I had a lot left, but like I said, I just kind of forgot about it. I started using other face masks, and at this point, I'm pretty sure it's expired. I think I did try it while I thought it was expired, and it was like starting to like give me irritation. Like my skin was just really itchy, and that's when I was like, yeah, it's gotta go. So I do like it. I would recommend it if you're looking for an affordable skincare line. We have another skincare product. I forgot all about this. This is the Glow Getter Nourishing Cleanser from Shea Moisture. I do believe I did a video on this. I better have. Otherwise, I'm gonna definitely rebuy it because this was a really cool cleanser, and I do have the moisturizer and I'm still using that up. I like this line. It's definitely not for everyone because the moisturizer can be feeling a little bit oily. It's like a very shiny moisturizer. Whereas this was cool. It had like a clay consistency once you apply water. But I do like the cleanser. I think it's great. Very affordable. I love Shea Moisture. Last but not least, we have another hair product. This is from Mixed Chicks. This is their Curl Sculptor. This is 8 fluid ounces. I did like it. I have no complaints on this product. I've tried a couple things from Mixed Girls and I do like it. Though I will say this one didn't like blow me away. I think I prefer some of their other styling products as opposed to this one, but I did use it up. I do like it. It's not bad by any means. And yeah, I'm trying to remember if there's anything else I have to say about that one, but not really, no. All right, so that is everything I have used up for the past couple of months. I've done these videos before in the past, but I always film it on a day where something happens to the footage or I just don't like how I look and I never end up putting it up. And then I end up tossing those products before I realize that that video is not gonna get put up, and then I should just refilm it, but the products are gone and it just feels weird talking about an empties product video without empties in it. I'm talking too fast, sorry. This time I'm actually gonna upload this video and it's gonna be great. It's gonna be a great time. So if you made it to the end of this video, thank you so much for watching. I really, really appreciate it, and I will see you very soon with another video. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and until next time, bye.